分享一下，我的婚姻好了。
I'd like to share about my wedding. My marriage.
跟奉主耶稣圣名见证。
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I bear witness.
感谢主，我从以前到2014年以前都觉得我应该不会结婚。
Up to the year of 2014, I didn't think I would ever be married.
因为我自己觉得我对神的了解。
Because I felt that my understanding of God.
就是我观察我自己，还有我一生到那个时候，我都觉得神应该有给我独生的恩赐。
Observing myself, I felt like all my life, maybe God has already given me the gift of singleness.
但是我自己从对真理的认识知道，人应该是要结婚的。
But through the truth, Bible study, I understand that it's normal for a person to be married.
所以我勉励别人都是说要结�n哦。
So I always encourage other people, we need to be married.
人家跟你介绍的时候要去祷告，不要一下子就说不。
And then if people want to introduce you or matchmake you with someone in a church, don't refuse them, but instead take the time to pray about a matter.
那也很特别的就是，我到2014年以前，我已经要满35岁，都还没有人跟我介绍过。
The interesting thing was up to the year 2014, I was almost 35 years old, and never once did anyone say that they were going to introduce someone to me for marriage.
所以这个对我来说也是一个 sign, 就是 我其实神设立我没有要让我可以不用结婚。
And so I took it as a sign that God permitted me to have a gift of singleness for the rest of my life.
那在2014年的二月底的时候。
And then at the end of February of 2014,
有一个传道娘突然叫我过去。
And suddenly a pastor's wife called me to talk to her privately.
就说依云啊，我之前是好像有听说过你是说你没有要结婚的。
And she said, I have heard in the past the rumor that you would like to remain single, you don't want to be married.
因为你是要做传道。
And because you are looking to become a preacher for the Lord.
说对啊。
And I said, yes, that's true.
那他就说，可是我还是在祷告，最近祷告有一个很强的感动，我觉得还是要告诉你。
Preacher's wife continued to explain, I have been praying for you and had a strong urge to share with you something that I had inspiration in a prayer.
就是反正他讲到后来就是他要介绍一个弟兄给我了。
And so at the very end, her conclusion was that she would like to introduce a brother to me.
那我就想，那我因为都跟人家说，人家跟你介绍，你要去祷告啊。
And then I thought to myself, since I always encourage other people, if people introduce you to someone, that you need to take the opportunity to pray about this matter before you reject them.
所以我也要照这个道理来行。
And so I must carry out my own advice.
所以我就说，那我就去祷告。
And so I said to the sister, okay, I will pray about this matter.
那他就问有没有什么条件呢？
And then a sister asked me, do you have any sort of requirements for your marital spouse?
我就说不能影响我的侍奉。
And my requirement was that this husband will not affect my servitude toward the Lord.
那这个是我唯一的条件。
And this is my only requirement.
所以他就说，那神学生可以吗？
And then so she went on to further ask me, would you be willing to consider someone who is also going to be a preacher, another TTP student?
我说，可是神学生都已经结婚了。
And then I said to her, I thought all the TTP students are already married.
她说传道呢？
And then she said, how about preachers?
我说那传道不是更加的全部都结婚了吗？台湾有两百多位传道，我据我所知每一个都结婚了。
And then she said, well, what about a preacher? I said, I thought all the preachers are already married. I don't think there's any single preachers right now that exist in our church.
她说没有，还有一个。
And she said, no, there is one preacher that is single.
我说谁？
I said, who is that?
她说宋怀，就是后来是我先生了。
And she mentioned the name of my current husband.
我很惊讶，因为我其实不认识他。
And I was very shocked because I didn't know this person.
我第一次知道他是我们其他神学生在聊天的时候有人提到他。
And I only know his name because other TTP students had this in our discussion somehow mentioned this person's name.
那就是讲他曾经怎么样鼓励过他们。或者怎么样关怀过他们，都是一些让我听了觉得，哇，这种事情我应该做不到，就是很尊敬这个人。
And from all the things that I heard about this man, they have all mentioned how this person encouraged them, how this person helped them, and from all the good the stories I've heard about this person, I've always really admired him for what he has contributed to the body of Christ.
所以当那个时候我就想，哇，这么好的人，他一定神有给他预备很好的配偶了。
And I've always thought that such a good person like this, I'm sure God has arranged a very good wife for him.
结果当这个传道娘说出这个名字，我真的很惊讶，他还没有结婚。
And then so it was to my shock that when this minister's wife mentioned his name to me. I was very shocked that he had not yet been married.
所以我就想，那可以考虑。
And so I said to her, yes, I will be willing to consider him.
因为就是他已经是传道了。那
yes, he's already a preacher.
所以用想的会觉得，哇，这样我们可以一起同工。
And then I was.Thinking how wonderful it would be that both of us will be able to serve God together.
那我就说，那他家人是不是也可以支持圣工呢？
And so I further asked the question, how about his family? Would they be willing to support the both of us?
那就说，哦，他的父母都是很敬畏神，很自己也是很投入侍奉神的。
And she said that.His parents are also very God-fearing, and they themselves both are very devoted to serving the Lord in the church.
那我就觉得用想的，这个应该是一个很好的计划，就是神如果神是这样计划，这个真的是一个好计划。
And based my reasoning, I thought, this candidate is very good, and it would probably be very ideal for me.To marry this person, of course, it is only according to my own thinking.
那，传道娘也是说，其实同时间已经有好几个人都想要介绍我们。
And then the minister's wife said, actually, many people has already thought about introducing the two of you for a long time.
因为大家都觉得这会是一个很美好的计划。
Because many people think that this will be a very harmonious union.
那，但是我们都要去祷告，因为不能够是我们人觉得这样很好，所以很好。
And so even though we were matchmade, both of us felt that we need to pray about this matter because it should not be the will of man, but that rather the will of God that prevails.
所以我就回去，我就说好，那我要祷告一个礼拜。如果我能够知道这个是出于神的，那我们才真的开始介绍。如果不是出于神，那就可以结束，完全不用开始。
And then I said to her, I will go home and pray for 1 week. If God makes it clear to me that this is a possibility, then we can be introduced to one another. if I do not get a confirmation from the Lord, and I'd rather not even be introduced to him.
那我就开始祷告，那就像之前有跟大家分享过的。
And so I started to pray about this matter as I shared with you before.
已经 我已经持续蛮长一段时间都是跟神有很亲密的交通。
I have maintained for a long time a very intimate prayer relationship with God.
那所以如果我们平常跟神的关系已经蛮亲密的，你要问神事情其实很方便。
And so if you have a very close relationship with God, it actually is very easy to ask questions of the Lord and he would answer you right away.
所以我说祷告一个礼拜，可是其实我大概祷告两天我就有明白了。
And so even though I said I would pray for a week, actually after only 2 days of praying, I already received the answer from the Lord.
那人家常常会有一个问题说，我们怎么知道神的意思？
And so many people will ask, how do we know God's will? Or how did you know what was God's answer in prayer?
我想我在祷告婚姻的这个过程可以提供一个经验。
I can share with you my experience in praying about my marriage.
当我祷告说，神啊，这个是出于你的吗？
And so when I asked the Lord, Lord, is this of your doing? Is this coming from you?
结果神让我有很多荆棘在就是祷告的时候很多荆棘就跑出来。
And when I was praying, God led a lot of verses to come into my mind to remind me.
首先他先让我想到以色列人过约旦河。
Firstly, he gave an example of how the Israelites were crossing the Jordan River.
今天下午一开始的时候纯章弟兄也有讲到这个以色列人过约旦河。
And so this afternoon we had heard about the Israelites crossing the Jordan River.
神带领摩西过红海的时候是让红海先分开在他们面前给他们看到干地。
And so when God had led the Israelites across the Red Sea, God had first separated the waters so there was dry land for the Israelites to go before they crossed.
对，所以他们看见干地，很安心可以走。
And it was not until they saw the dry land that they felt comfortable to advance forward and cross the Red Sea.
但是带领以色列人要过约旦河，祭司面前那个河水还是很汹涌，而且那个时候刚好遇到涨潮，那个水更高。
And so when the Israelites were ready to cross the Jordan River, it was a different situation. The river was overflowing the banks at that time, and the waters were running very quickly.
所以祭司要有一个信心，因为神的话这样子吩咐，所以你就不要怀疑，脚就踏进去。
So the priest had to take up courage in your faith and to make the first step into the running river to see how God would open the river for them.
当你能够凭着对神的话、神的应许的相信，跨出那一步。
When you are able to have the faith to believe in God and to believe in His promises, and you take the first step in faith,
当你脚踏进那个河水里，水就会立时分开。
And with that step of faith, when you step down, then the waters will start to part for you.
路就会开启。
And then the road will be shown to you.
在那个婚姻的介绍来的时候，对我第一个 很大的疑虑，就是 我会担心我的侍奉会因此受到影响。
And during the consideration of this marriage, my greatest concern is that it will affect my servitude, my concentration focus on God.
一方面可能会怕人家就劝说你就 当传道娘就好，你不用不用当传道了。
And I was very afraid that after getting married, people would tell me, oh, you need to be a minister's wife now. That is your role. You shouldn't be a preacher anymore.
那或者是如果有怀孕的怎么办呢？
Or what if I got pregnant?
那或者是我是属连总，他是属台总台湾。那如果我以后要被派到国外，那他还在台湾怎么办呢？
And what if since my TPP training is through the IA, and he is a minister of the GA, we will be separated in different countries, and how are we going to reconcile that?
所以虽然一开始觉得哇，这样两个传道可以一起同工很好。
So at first, the first thought that two preachers will be living together and serving God together may seem like a good idea.
但是如果仔细想现实，你要怎么处理这些问题，你就会觉得啊，没有路啊。
But then when you try to think of the details of all the problems, then you realize that there's a lot of issues you need to deal with.
当我们看现实的时候，常常都会让我们害怕。
And when we see the things that are in reality happening, then a lot of times we'll feel very fearful.
会觉得没有路。
We may think that there is no further path to walk anymore.
但是神让我，神告诉我这个以色列人过约旦河。
But God reminded me of the crossing the Jordan River by the Israelites.
在你眼前是滔滔的河水，看起来没有路。
And though in front of you see the raging waters, and it seems like there is no more path to walk.
但是，如果你相信这个是出于神的预备
，But if you truly believe that this is the preparation, the plan of God,
相信神必开路
，And then you should believe that God will open a way for you.
那就勇敢踏出那一步。
And so with braveness and courage, we need to make the first step.
凭着信心踏出的那一步，就会看见开启的路。
And a step made in faith, you will immediately see how God will open the way for you.
那我就继续又祷告，那接下来又出现另一段经节。
And I continued to pray, and then the second passage appeared in my mind.
就是以色列派十二个探子去看迦南地。
The Israelites sent out 12 spies to survey the land of Canaan.
其中十个探子都是回来呼天抢地，就是哭啊，说太可怕了，那个地方的居民要把我们吞吃了。
And then 10 of the spies came back and cried in fear.And alarmed everyone that we would not be able to conquer that land because that land is full of giants.
对啦，那里的水果很大，那里的出产很不错，可是那里的人太可怕了。
It is true, the produce there is very big and very plentiful, but the people there are so scary and frightening.
另外两个就是加勒和约书亚。
But the other two out of the 12 spies, which is Joshua and Caleb,
其实他们看见的是同样的事实。
They saw the same event unfold before their eyes.
但是他们却不是只看见这个 表面。
But they did not look only at the surface of the matter.
他们看见那里，也看见那里的物产很丰富啊。
They saw how beautiful and that land was and how productive the produce was.
他们也看见那里的人很高大。
And they also saw that there were giants in that land.
但是因为他们知道神应许要把这个地方赏赐给他们。
But they knew in their hearts that God had promised them the land of Canaan.
这个是神要赏赐的。
That God was willing to grant it to them.
所以这是神的祝福。
And this is a blessing of God.
虽然看起来有一些困难在当中。
And even though there are difficulties they need to surmount.
就是说那些高大的人他是真的确实存在没有错。
And it's true that they need to conquer and overcome those giants.
但是既然是神所预备的 必然是最好的。
But they trust that God will prepare the best for them.
那些困难，神也必定预备了方法来让他们超越这些困难。
And that all those difficulties that they will face, they will always find a way through God.
所以两个探子是用信心的眼睛来看神的预备。
So the two spies, saw the situation through the eyes of faith.
那十个会看这个神的预备是一个灾难，就是因为他们只看现实而不看神的应许。
And why the other 10 spies were so discouraged and fearful was because they only looked at the reality, but they never looked at God.
所以看一件事情，如果它是出于神的，你是要把它看作一个灾难还是一个祝福？
And so today, whatever that God permits to happen to our lives, do you want to view it as a calamity or you want to view it as a blessing?
所以这个婚姻，神让我想到这样的经节，我就明白，这个是神摆在我眼前的，从他来的。你要觉得这是一个灾难还是一个祝福？
And so when God reminded me of this passage, he was telling me that, do you want to view this marriage proposal as a calamity or tribulation or a blessing that God wants to give to you.
所以这时候我就已经大概明白神的意思。
And I kind of understood what God was trying to say.
那我又有一个疑问啦。
And then I had a question.
可是如果这个婚姻会跟我的服事有矛盾冲突怎么办？
What if this marriage causes problems or conflicts with my servitude to the Lord?
那我有这个疑问出来的时候，神又用圣灵带领我想到另外一个观念。
And then after I asked this question, God used the Holy Spirit to lead me to another thought.
婚姻是神所设立的。
Marriage has been instituted by God.
是神在创造世界的时候就设立。
It was established at the dawn of creation.
就是说，在神创造完人之后设立这个婚姻。
It was established early on, as soon as he created humans.
所以他也给人一个命令，要生养众多，遍满全地。
And therefore, God gave a command that man is to be fruitful and multiply to inherit the earth.
另外，侍奉神也是神让神给人的一个吩咐。
And another command of God is that we need to serve God.
就是一生，你活着的一生都是在侍奉神。
And your whole life, as you live and breathe, you're serving the Lord in everything you do.
神是一个不会自我矛盾的神。
But God is not a God of self-conflict or paradox.
所以既然两件事都是他要人去做的，他就不会去设立一个让人做结了婚就没办法顾到另侍奉他。
And therefore, God will not set up marriage such that after you become married, you cannot serve God anymore.
神，人的心呢，真的是掌握在神手中。
And our hearts are in the hands of God.
在圣灵带领下，我的心就渐渐顺服。
And after the guidance, understanding the guidance of the Holy Spirit, I started to submit to the Holy Spirit.
所以我就可以去接受。去想到原来我的侍奉要在婚姻里完成。
And there I started to understand that it was God's will that my servitude to him will be completed in the context of being married.
就是说不只是婚姻不会来影响侍奉。
Not only will marriage not affect my servitude for him.
相反的是要借着婚姻来完成侍奉。
It is on the opposite that the marriage is there to help me complete my servitude and perfect my servitude.
所以，经过这样子的祷告，那是某一天某一次的祷告。
And that was, through this prayer, and that was one prayer at a certain time, certain day.
那，我说要有一个礼拜时间给我祷告，那所以剩下来的四五天，我还是继续祷告。
So the remaining 4 or 5 days, I continued to pray for this matter, even though I had already received my preliminary answer from the Lord.
一方面继续跟神确认，真的是这样哦，我没有误解你的意思哦。
I continued to reconfirm the Lord that what I received is truly from you, and this is what you meant, that I did not misunderstand you.
那另一方面，更加的是去求顺服。
And the other times also was to pray to God to give me a heart of submission.
因为原本想的是，就是从来没有把婚姻放到我对我未来的想象中。
Because I never really ever imagined that I would become married.
所以今天突然要变成有结婚，那我觉得这个对我来说是一个很重大的改变。
And to actually be able to accept the idea of becoming married is actually a very big change in the concept for me.
所以我就算知道这个是出于神，然后要我去执行，我觉得我还是需要顺服。
And even though I know that this is the will of God, however, I needed more strength from Him so that I can submit to Him.
所以接下来祷告就是一直去求神让我顺服。
And so I continue to pray to God for a submissive heart.
神真的是一个不会去勉强人。辖制人的神。
And our God is truly a God that does never force anyone to do something he doesn't want to do.
之前从来没人跟我介绍。
And before no one ever introduced anyone else to me for marriage.
但是在那个时候突然就有三个机会出现。
But it was at that moment, all of a sudden, I had 3 marriage introductions.
其中有除了这一位传道娘介绍的这个传道我不认识，另外两位我都认识，而且我都很觉得他们很好。
And there's two other introductions, and these were two brothers I already knew, and I know them to be very good brothers as well.
那所以我就跟神祷告说，神啊，现在是怎么回事
？And then so I returned back to prayer to ask God what happened here.I thought it was so clear, but now I'm so confused. Why is there 3?
Okay, 你要我结婚，那我了解了，但是是哪一个？
I understand you want me to get married, and I will submit to that, but which one did you want me to pick?
所以我就一个一个祷告。
And so I prayed for one candidate after another.
如果是照我以前，就是理性上，没有祷告的时候的我的选择，我应该会选，假设 A B C， 我大概会选 A。
And if I were to go according to my own thoughts and my own rationale, I would probably go with a candidate A, the first one that was introduced to me.
不是说第一个，就是反正我现在随便给他们代号。那其中有一个是我理性上会选的。
Excuse me, I meant I would pick my own choices among the 3 according to what I liked or what I disliked.
可是在祷告当中，圣灵带领很奇妙。
While I was praying, the guidance of the Holy Spirit was indeed very wonderful.
祷告另外那两位的时候，没有特别什么想法。
And when I was praying for the other 2 people, I didn't have any sort of inspiration at all.
可是当我祷告到这个传道娘介绍的这位传道的时候，
When I was praying for the candidate who was already a preacher,
有一个很奇妙的喜悦跑出来。
All of a sudden, I had this very wonderful joy come out of my heart.
而且有一个盼望。
And I had this hope.
那个盼望我也不知道是从哪里来的，就是 祷告这个人的时候，会觉得我们有未来。
And I don't know where that hope came from, but when I was praying for this candidate, I felt like we had a future together.
虽然我们不认识。
Even though we didn't know each other at all.
可是这个在灵里头的喜乐跟盼望是圣灵带领出来的。
But this unexplainable spiritual joy and spiritual hope that came out of the prayer was something that I know was clearly the guidance of the Holy Spirit.
所以，后来我就跟那个传道娘回复说，可以介绍。
And so I replied to the preacher's wife and said, please go ahead with the marriage introduction.
因为我已经得到主耶稣告诉我的答案了。
I have received a confirmation from the Lord.
所以我们就开始认识沟通。
And so we started to communicate with one another.
那我们用三个月的时间这样沟通，并且一起为这个事情祷告。
And for 3 months, we took the time to communicate with one another and also to pray about this marriage.
所以我们很少见面。
We hardly met together.
我们互相沟通的内容也都是侍奉或者是信仰的体验。
And in our conversations, it focused solely on God and also the holy work of God.
所以我们避免让自己的情感放进去。
And the experiences we had in our faith.And we both avoided putting any affection or emotions into our relationship.
因为我们要非常非常确定这个真的是神所预备的另一半，那才可以开始放感情。
Because we wanted to be absolutely sure that this is what God has arranged to us before we put in any of our heart into it.
所以我们一起祷告了三个月之后就觉得需要做决定了。
And after 3 months of praying about this matter together, we both decided we need to make a final decision.
所以因为中间有一段时间都是只要又讲到现实，我们就觉得好像很困难欸。
Because during our communication, we found that every time we talked about our practical situation and issues,It was really like an impossibility for us to face.
那所以后来我们就觉得，我们一起禁食祷告一个礼拜，然后跟神问到底是不是，是就结婚，不是就结束。
And so finally, we decided that we will both fast for 1 week and ask the Lord to confirm, absolutely sure that this is what God intended for us. And then at the end of 1 week.Then we'll make a decision.
那其实，在那个三个月里面，我们各自祷告，但是我自己这部分，我的祷告已经越来越明确，对，就是他。但是我还是把最后的答案，就是还是要做一个最后的确认。
Even so, I was pretty sure. During my 3 months of prayer that it was God's will, yet I thought it was still good to verify with the one final week of prayer.
那我自己在很确定的一些祷告里面，其中一个就是神让我在祷告婚姻，但是神却让我回到起初被他感动呼召献身的那个时候的祷告。
And one of those prayers, God reminded me of the time when I first became very close to him, and I was so touched that I had to give my whole life to serving him.
所以等于是在祷告婚姻中，神让我回到献身服事的心智，所以让我明白这个婚姻跟我的侍奉将会是结合在一起。
And so, God was reminding me that this marriage will help with the servitude. That the marriage and the servitude are supposed to be together.
结果很奇妙的就是，在那个 一个礼拜禁食祷告，最后我们见面摊牌。
And so at the end of the 7 days, we met each other to make our final decision.
他就见证说，其实他这个礼拜很忙。
And he testified that actually he was very busy this whole week.
因为要去准备一些课程。
Because he has to prepare some curriculum.
结果就是在准备一个青年的课程，是在讲侍奉的心。
And while he was preparing a youth curriculum material, he was talking about heart of servitude.
结果他自己在准备以及上台讲 那一刻的时候，他被 很大的感动。
And so while he was preparing the materials and when he went up to the pulpit to deliver the sermon, he was greatly touched by the word of God.
那个感动是他已经很久以来没有达到的感动。
And that type of strong movement from the Holy Spirit is something that he hasn't experienced in a long time.
那是他在高中那个时候有一次在灵恩会被大大感动，很深的感动之后，他立志要从那时候他开始立志要献身。
And that strong movement reminded him of the time when he was in high school and he had gone to a spiritual convocation. It was that in one prayer where God had greatly moved him to make him make the determination that he would serve God the rest of his life.
结果他竟然就在为婚姻祷告的这一个礼拜当中回到了那个当初的热情。
And it was this zeal from the beginning that he experienced again in that very week.
所以我们的结论是一致的。
And so our conclusion was in unison.
就是神借着我们的这个婚姻让我们来服侍他。
And it was God's will that this marriage shall fulfill his requirement of servitude from both of us.
而且让我们都再一次的回到献身的这个感动的起点。
And he reminded both of us back to the beginning point of our love with God.
所以婚姻是我们人生的一个新的起点。
And so this marriage was a beginning point, a new beginning for our journey of faith and servitude with the Lord.
对，也是我们侍奉神的一个新的起点。那所以这个过程，我觉得对于我们去认识神的旨意，还有怎么样去回应神的旨意，这个过程。可以跟大家来分享。
And so I hope sharing this experience will help give you an example of what it's like to pursue to understand the will of God in decision making during one's life.
那我想顺服是很重要的一个部分。
And I believe that submission is a very important component of a Christian's faith.
感谢神，就是我们都顺服，结果我们现在很幸福。
So we really thank God that because we both submitted to the Lord, we really enjoy a very blessed marriage.
那愿一切的荣耀归给天上真神。
May all glory be unto the Lord.